Hi, I'm Anastasia Koivikko from Tampere University, Finland, and now I will present our recent work on bio-inspired tactile pressure sensors, which are also biodegradable, flexible, and transparent.
The sensors are based on rubber leaf skeletons. We have previously reported fabric-based tactile pressure sensors and plant-based tactile pressure sensors. These sensors were used in robotic hand applications, and the plant-based sensor was biodegradable, but not transparent. We chose the capacitive sensing method for the pressure measurements because of many advantages the method has. Usually the sensitivity and the speed of the sensor are high, and the sensor structure is quite simple. Also, the power consumption of the sensor is usually quite low. The other advantages of the sensor are that it doesn't usually have direct contact with the skin, and it's sealed from the dirt. Also, the sensor can be made of many different materials like plastic, metal, and liquid. One big motivation for this work is the globally growing problem of electronic waste, so-called e-waste. That's the waste of all electronic and electrical goods which are no longer in their intended use. These components include computers, cell phones, and, for example, medical sensors. One major issue with electronic waste is that it often contains hazardous components. And then, when it's dismantled and processed, environment and people who are handling are exposed for these materials. And that's why, in this work, we propose biodegradable, non-toxic, and transparent capacitive pressure sensor.
So how were the leaf-based electrodes fabricated? First, the leaf skeleton was dipped in the cetrimonium bromide solution, and that was let dry at the room temperature overnight. Then the leaf skeleton was placed inside the hydrophobic petri dish with the silver-nanowire solution and let dry in the ambient conditions for 1 hour. And finally, the skeleton was placed on hot plate for 30 minutes at 100 degrees Celsius. Here you can see the scanning electron microscopy images of the leaf skeleton with silver nanowires with three different resolutions. And finally, we wanted to confirm the presence of silver nanowires on the leaf skeleton, so we did the energy dispersive spectrometry measurements for the skeleton.
Then we characterized the fabricated leaf electrode. First, we use it as a conductor in the LED circuit, and we can see from the figure that it conducts even if it's bent. Then we measured the resistance during different curvature conditions, and we can see that the change in resistance is negligible even if the electrode is bent from 0 to 600 inverse meters. We also checked the stability of the electrode. We measured the resistance under different temperature conditions, and we can see that the resistance is stable under 180 degrees Celsius. After that, the resistance increases rapidly, which can be due to breaking of the silver nanowires. The last step was to measure the transparency of the electrodes. We can see that the transmittance of the electrodes with and without tape is in the range of 50 to 70%, and the transmittance of the sensor is around 20%, which is a decent see-through sensor. So after the characterization of the leaf-based electrodes, we fabricated the capacitive pressure sensor. These transparent leaf electrodes were used as a top and bottom electrode of a capacitive sensor. Then we attached double-sided cellulose-based tape to the top electrode and similar but single-sided tape to the bottom electrode. Then we stuck these electrodes together. And the whole sensor was encapsulated with the also cellulose-based encapsulation tape. The initial capacitance of the sensor depends on the distance D1 between these two electrodes. And then, when pressure is applied on the sensor, the distance D1 will decrease, which corresponds to the increase of the sensor capacitance. Then we characterize the fabricated capacitive precessions. First, we measured the relative capacitance under different pressure load from 0.1 kPa under 37.4 kPa. The blue line is fitted second order polynomial and the red dots are average of 5 repeated measurements. We also calculated the sensitivity of the sensor from the previous capacitance pressure data, and we can see that the highest sensitivity was achieved with the lowest applied pressures. The dynamic behavior of the sensor was studied by applying 12.5 kPa cyclic load with 2.0 Hz frequency and for around 2.5 hours. The relative capacitance was recorded for that time. We can see that the sensor has low drift, but it's quite stable for a shorter period of time. The hysteretic behavior of the sensor was also studied. We repeatedly loaded and unloaded the sensor and recorded the relative capacitance, applied pressure, and distance of the probe. The black line is average of 5 repeated measurements. We can see that the sensor behaves quite hysteretically, but on the other hand, it's quite linear. Part of the hysteresis is from the geometric deformations of the sensor, which can be seen in the inset of the figure. Finally, we studied the degradability of the sensor. The cellulose-based tape can be considered biodegradable, and the silver is non-toxic and non-reactive in biological processes. The leaf skeletons were kept in tap water for 100 days, and it was visually confirmed that there is significant degradation in 100 days. So we can conclude that the sensor is non-toxic and biodegradable. In conclusion, we fabricated plant material-based biodegradable capacitive tactile pressure sensors. The electrodes we used in the sensors were rubber leaf skeleton-based, and those are transparent, breathable, flexible, and low-cost. The whole sensor is biodegradable and non-toxic because of the tape we used is cellulose-based biodegradable tape, and the leaf skeletons are also biodegradable. The silver nanowires are non-toxic and non-reactive in biological processes. The sensor has high sensitivity, which is comparable with current state-of-art capacitive sensors. And these sensors may help reduce the carbon footprint and help with the global e-waste problem. The potential future applications for the sensors are prosthetics, like electronic skin, wearable electronics, soft robotics, and sensors in healthcare monitoring. In the end, I would like to thank the whole Bioinspired Materials and Robotics group. Thank you.